This is a highly controversial video. It's extremely difficult to define subcontinents. Quite possibly the only part of Earth that we can unanimously agree that's a subcontinent is South Asia. After that, it tends to get pretty complicated, especially the way you decide to divide up Europe. That is why for this video, I'm choosing to divide up the subcontinents by using an already established map. An already established map and quite possibly one of the most famous map games of all time. This game, Risk, naturally has to divide up the world map into subcontinents, so that's what we're going to be using today. You know, the problem is there's several different types of maps that the board game Risk uses, so we're going with only one of them. I absolutely love the name of these subcontinents because they're definitely going to start a conversation. For instance, we have Northern Europe, that's just Denmark, Germany, the Netherlands, maybe a little bit of Belgium. Then we have Scandinavia, which doesn't include Denmark, but does include Finland. Oh boy, classic mistake there. I feel like a lot of people would agree that Central America is its own subcontinent in a way. This one could be more accurate. And South America is divided in between Venezuela, Brazil, Peru, and Argentina. I guess f*** all those other places, right? I would argue there is definitely a Middle East subcontinent, but to not include Egypt is rather interesting. And then just to give them Libya for absolutely no reason. I get giving them Sudan, right? But why have them manifest destiny westward? That makes no sense. I love that New Zealand has literally just been yeeted. Also, you'll notice the naval crossings are accurate to the game, at least some versions of the map. Statistically speaking, at the start of the game, North Africa is the largest subcontinent. They do have a huge chunk here, and then China is in a solid second, very close behind Greenland and Brazil and Ukraine. This is going to be interesting. I have no idea who's going to come out on top here. First of all, can I just say if this was actually a real life war, like this Western United States versus this Eastern United States, we in the West would absolutely get our butts handed to us. Like, this is not even close. This is so overwhelmingly one-sided. I just wanted to point that out. The vast majority of Americans live on this side, and that also means they're making a lot more money. There's really only a couple spots out here in the West that could even come close to matching the East. I'd like to add this map was technically divided in 1957 by this French filmmaker, so things were a little bit different back then. We already have our first war. It is Venezuela versus Peru, and then we have Northern Europe versus Southern Europe. I forgot to say that the Balkans are included in Southern Europe. Western Europe, and then just Great Britain. Man, this is gonna be funny. We also have Egypt versus the Middle East, Western Australia, and Eastern Australia, which I'm pretty sure the Australians are dealing with the same thing we are in the US. This was an actual real life war, Eastern Australia would absolutely obliterate Western Australia. We also have Siam or Indochina versus China, and they're really, oof, okay, wow, you're getting absolutely demolished. Wow, one-sided. We also have the Eastern US going after Ontario and Alberta. Look at these interesting alliances that are beginning to form too. North Africa is just allied to the Congo and Brazil, so they're not planning on moving across the Atlantic just yet. Interesting, New Guinea going after Indonesia, but that war is immediately stopped. There's a whole lot of territory in this part of the map with like about 13 people. I'm specifically looking at this region here. I don't know why Russia was divided so heavily, but again, if you think about the way the Risk map and the Risk game is played, it makes more sense. Oh wow, Southern Europe pretty much just got banished to just Italy. Also, Western Europe just fell to Northern Europe. For some reason, Iceland is its own subcontinent, but I would definitely give that to Greenland. I'm so glad that I didn't have to make this map myself. I believe I have made a subcontinent versus subcontinent video in the past. People were so mad. Wow, and just like that, Venezuela is gone. Now we have Peru versus Brazil. We have South Africa versus Eastern Africa. Also, Madagascar is involved in that. For some reason, Western Australia's capital is not Perth. I have no idea why they'd put it in the middle of the desert like this, but okay. Ooh, then we have India versus a very big China, who's probably number one in the world now. No, actually, China's in third. Brazil is catching up because they just took a lot of territory from Peru. Holy crap, I made that whole statement to say how strong Eastern United States is, and they're already gone. Ontario, Canada wiped them out and took pretty much everything. Okay, well, it is up to just the West, at least if you're rooting for the US. Oh, and North Africa took a lot, pretty much all of Iberia perfectly too. Wow, that's like way too perfect of borders. The Italians or Southern Europe is, oh, there goes the Congo. Did Belgium have anything to do with that? Somehow Western Australia has survived. They survived longer than the Eastern United States. We also have Afghanistan in a three-way war. Okay, don't get into a three-way. Afghanistan might fall, but this is called the Graveyard of Empires. Don't forget that. Now we have Northern Europe with the help of Great Britain fighting Ukraine and Scandinavia. Japan is its own little island right now for now. Afghanistan still fighting these two provinces here in Russia. Oh, and they survived. Very interesting alliances forming up. Pretty much everyone has a team, or at least almost. Once again, no matter what, Spanish Latin America always teams up to fight Brazil. I've noticed that in like all these games. It's gonna be hard to get to Peru because they have to move. Oh, never mind. Okay, I take that back. And they're probably gonna take Buenos Aires very soon. They're literally knocking on the doorstep. We have Northern Africa moving in after Southern Africa. Also, Western Western United States trying to gain some territory back from the East, which is controlled by Ontario. Who's giving them money? Is that Brazil? Northern Germany's looking awfully like a no-no. Northern Europe's looking awfully like no-no Germany, kind of here with the France controls, and they're probably going to be expanding out east. I don't know how Iceland is still alive. That's incredible. And there goes Argentina. So Brazil already has a monopoly. Brazil actually might be the biggest power, I think. It's going to be very close. And the Japanese, I believe, took out the easternmost state. Oh, there's going to be a little bit of a jump here. The easternmost subcontinent, I guess I should say. Okay, so Alaska might be attacking Asia soon. Now we have the Middle East moving in after Afghanistan. Interesting that Afghanistan was not included in... Well, this is India. It's interesting they didn't call this just South Asia. Also, Southern Europe is still alive, and they might survive for a little bit because it's going to be hard to get actually to Rome, which is where their capital is placed. Meanwhile, Northern Europe's capital is Berlin. Berlin might be... hard to defend. Canada's still fighting itself. Western U.S. really hasn't moved much at all, but wow, they have a lot of friends. Brazil does not have to worry about their eastern front just yet, so they might be making moves up towards the north. There is no Caribbean, though. That's going to make it difficult for the AI. That's why this World War Simulator game is going to be unlike anything else that we've seen, because the map is just so freaking weird. We also have Ukraine. Oh, taking Berlin. There you go. So maybe Northern Europe will get backstabbed by the British, because, I mean, now their capital's in Paris. A lot easier for the Brits to get to Paris, I think. Ukraine's now fighting a two-front war. Oh, against Afghanistan with the help of the Middle East. I feel like as more and more nations die here, the more the subcontinent part of this video is going to look more realistic. Is that Greenland? Wow, Greenland is literally taking over so much of North Africa, and all the North African countries are trying to push them out, which is definitely possible. They have to go all the way up here, though, and all the way around. That's gonna suck. Oh, look, Western U.S. took out Quebec. They also took out almost Mexico or Central America. Somehow, the Western Australians are slowly starting to beat back the Eastern Australians. Statistically, Brazil is number one in terms of area, and they're allied to the number two power, North Africa. Look at the Western U.S. go. They're now third, and they have all these friends. And the richest country is actually the Ural part of Russia. Almost all... Wow, this is looking like a communist alliance, except without Ukraine. North Africa has made it to the boot of Italy. Now they're just trying to drive their way to Rome. Egypt still survives somehow. They're actually pushing slightly into the Arabian Peninsula here. And with the help of Indonesia, Western Australia is looking better and better. Japan began to slowly colonize the Korean Peninsula, but they've just been pushed out by Mongolia. Let's see if the Mongolians can finally master boats. We also have East Africa also landing in the Arabian Peninsula, but they're also fighting North Africa as well. Is this capital in Mali? Is this Mansa Musa, the richest man in history, leading this? I mean, they've got a lot of gold. Are they going to just buy nations to get their victory? They're also now moving around this mountain range and into southern France. Oh, Iceland has been destroyed, and they've also been split. This island's been split between Greenland and the British. If the Western U.S. doesn't backstab somebody here, I know they probably like to have friends, but you're not going to be able to grow at all. Also, ew, what is up with these borders here? Now, Egypt is really expanding into the Middle East. They're getting very, very close to that Arabian capital. Are you running out of money? Are you guys not even going to defend yourself? I don't understand. Okay, there they go. They're going to start to defend a little bit. Somehow, Southern Europe is still going while fighting Ukraine, and they're actually gaining land a little bit in the Balkans. North Africa, again, is attacking Northern Europe, but they just got pushed out of Southern France now. Without the normal sea crossings, the AI is having a little bit of trouble jumping off into different continents, although Mongolia landed in the south of Japan. And there go the Japanese. Finally, Mongolia has conquered their enemy, I guess their rival that they never could. Holy crap, India just exploding through the south of China. Also, I don't know how southern Italy is still going. They're just trapped on the peninsula. Oh my goodness, and look at Brazil lose a little bit. Okay, is Brazil running out of money? Brazil's not running out of money yet. Central America, I don't know where that came from. A little bit of bat. Okay, Greenland might take over all of North America. It's definitely a possibility of that. Finally, Southern Europe has been conquered mostly from North Africa. I think they did a lot of the damage, but probably with Ukraine's help. And there goes Ukraine. And they were taken out by Afghanistan. Crazy. Middle East is still surviving just barely. Oh, things are getting really weird looking in Europe. We've got the North Africans, the Egyptians, the Afghanistanians, the Afghani. I don't know why I say that weird. Oh, and there goes the Middle East. Okay, so this continent is almost unrecognizable, although Northern Europe is kind of making a comeback, and the Scandinavians are doing okay up here. Slowly, the Russian region is getting cleaned up. Bam, and there goes, I don't even know who that was. It's Greenland, though, that has a majority of North America. I knew it. This is the prediction that we made. Brazil's just stuck down here because they don't want to go to war with North Africa, but they can't move through the Central Asian territory. Wow, somehow Northern Europe too, fighting everyone from all sides. Afghanistan's looking pretty good right now, but they're surrounded by a lot of neighbors. Even if they're friendly with a lot of them, for now, those friendships always break down. Ooh, well, we finally see the fall of Western Australia, who I don't know. I can't believe they're still going. Western U.S. is not looking good because they're about to get tag-teamed by Greenland and the Northern West Territories, which is weird to use directional language. Like, that is actually what it's called, Northwestern Territories. That's like the province name, right? Meanwhile, we have like Northern Europe, North Africa. These are not actual real places. These are just subcontinent names. Afghanistan and China have teamed up to take out a majority of Russia. This is pretty much the only real Russian place that remains. Oh my goodness. And Northern Europe has backstabbed Britain. That means that this is the only European nation left. You have enough friends? You're friendly with Egypt. There is 14 nations completely. Oh my goodness. And Eastern Europe did finally take out Eastern Australia took out Western Australia. Right now they're teaming up with Indonesia, but we'll see for how long that stands. Ah, and there we go. The Western U.S. did take out Central America. Oh, and now they're expanding north where they might be able to get to that capital. There goes possibly East Africa, but man, India's really funding that war. Egypt did collapse, or did they just get annexed by Greenland? Oh, I didn't even realize that the Europeans fell. Why is Greenland so powerful? This is crazy, Greenland. I think that was a unification that I missed. India again trying to fight Afghanistan. Oh, it might be China that takes over all that. Wow, China doing amazing here. They actually didn't start off that great, but they are starting to look like they normally do in this game. Really powerful. Afghanistan's technically number one in terms of area. How is that China looks wait, Afghanistan, North Africa, China's third? They look way bigger than third. There's gonna have to be a power that forms, I think, out of the West, because a lot of these nations I think are gonna get crushed by China. And look, there goes Afghanistan's capital. They had to move it to Ukraine. Brazil did finally backstab North Africa. They needed to do that. Oh, and they grabbed the capital too. Okay, now you're gonna need East Africa's help in order to get all the way down here to the Congo. Oh man, and the Western U.S. is starting to make a slight comeback against Greenland. Afghanistan needs to ally to India, but right now they're at war. India and China are actually teaming up. Indonesia is starting to push into Eastern Australia, and China has landed in Alaska. There's 11 nations left. It actually looks like there's even less. I forget that there's still Madagascar here for some reason. They will probably get annexed. No, actually they just got killed by North Africa. Man, money is flying all over the place. Everyone's trying to support their allies. Of course, the alliances are changing very quick. I think there's only three factions right now. Who will win the war for North America? The thing is, Greenland is spread out pretty thin. They're fighting so many different wars. Gold-wise, the closest to zero is the Western U.S., so that's not good because their big enemy is Greenland, who obviously has a lot more gold. Oh, they're allied right now, though, so actually Greenland might help fund them a little bit in their war against Brazil. Brazil has, I think, one of the richest nations along with East Africa. That explains why North Africa has been doing so poorly. They had to move their capital all the way down to South Africa. And there goes the final Australian nation that was technically the East. They had to move their capital to the West briefly. Okay, so Indonesia has just become a huge player in this game because they now only have to worry about one front. They're also not allied to India, so they're actually allied to Afghanistan. This is going to help Afghanistan as well. India and China are also still allied. This is a big world war. There's lots of world wars happening right now. I don't know who is going to win this. And bam, there they go. Okay, I knew that that was going to happen. Also, Greenland is beginning to fight wars against Brazil. I saw that. Brazil is obviously still fighting. Ooh, Brazil's fighting two different fronts now. If the East Africans can get to that capital, I think North Africa would finally fall. That would give Brazil a little bit more breathing room against Greenland in the north. The problem is East Africa's fighting a lot of big wars against Afghanistan. Wow, look at Afghanistan. They're huge. There's only eight nations left, but there's only major, like, two factions. There's only two factions, period. Period. I feel like I just had to add that because I said it like I wasn't confident. There is only two teams. And the walls are closing down on North Africa in South Africa. And okay, there they go. Okay, well, this changes everything. Now we have a Brazilian and, oh wow, that's an interesting team. Ooh, and the alliance between India and China finally broke down. China was tired of funding that war and India not making any progress against Afghanistan. This is literally anyone's game. There's seven nations left. Interesting that you can't jump from the Philippines to where there is no Taiwan. Interesting the way the Risk creator just didn't include Taiwan. Eventually, these alliances are going to start to break down if there's not more progress made. Oh, China almost took that Indian capital. Oh, China's run out of money. Oh my goodness. Are they going to actually do it right now, though? Yes, they did. They did not peace out in time. Afghanistan has all of China. Who is going? There's five nations left. Oh, when did East Africa annex Brazil? They had such similar colors. I completely missed that. Statistically speaking, East Africa is number one. Afghanistan has a long way to go. Of course, that means nothing. It's really all about the gold. And actually, you know what? If Indonesia has... Oh, Indonesia does not have much gold, I was going to say. Indonesia might get annexed, but if Indonesia had more gold, I could see them winning this possibly. Oh, I think I was looking at the wrong. This is the area category. It's actually extremely close. These are the top three. I was accidentally looking at gold before. So there's two like major minor players, India and Indonesia. The problem is that these two border each other, so they're not going to ally, and they're not really going to make much of a difference between the major three powers. It's just a matter of time before India either gets annexed or killed. If East Africa annexes, that's absolutely possible. They might annex them, but then it might be Afghanistan who annexes Indonesia. They also could get unified under. It'd be so hard to get to that Greenland capital because, like, there's such a big choke point on all sides. There's three big choke points to get there. Interesting, Afghanistan actually has no friends. They're not a part of an alliance yet. So it's pretty much the three big powers versus each other. Just two of them have minor powers over here. Afghanistan just lost their capital. There's now two big teams. It's Greenland and Afghanistan working together to try to take out East Africa and India. And India's actually making some progress in the north. Oh, and there goes India. Indonesia, don't count them out in this game yet. I was going to say, was this island just going to be uncolonized? They weren't moving for a second. And I think it wasn't moving. That territory wasn't moving because Afghanistan is dangerously... Oh, they ran out of money. Okay. Well, let's see how much they're going to lose before they collapse. Greenland just needs to pray. They've got money, but they're going to see their one ally collapse here, I think. There's still a possibility with maybe Indonesia. Now, Greenland is going to get a lot out of the collapse of Afghanistan. Wow. Look at Indonesia really fund this, but Indonesia does not have enough money. Well, this is smart by Indonesia because technically it's only Afghanistan that they border. They probably could give them all their funds and still be okay. East Africa's starting to tick down a little bit lower and lower. Oh, and Indonesia backstab. You gave them all that money and then you backstab them. Why did you do that? It's 2v2. Obviously, Indonesia is the smaller power allying to the stronger power. And then these two, Greenland and Afghanistan, they're trying their best to team up. A lot of money getting thrown around. Meanwhile, the world doesn't necessarily have a whole lot of money. Afghanistan actually has the most now. And there they go. Afghanistan's done. And then so is obviously Greenland now. Is there even a chance here? No, I don't think so for Indonesia. Bam, it was East Africa. In the middle of the map too. I mean, that is pretty impressive. I mean, East Africa and the Horn of Africa definitely considered a subcontinent. So subcontinent won the subcontinent battle royale. Look at that. And thank you to the patrons. You can go to the link in the description down below to patreon.com to support me.
John, Green, Denver,
best Jack girl. Triven's annoying
I
friend.
I can't sleep without Drew's voice.
Inquisitors,
Hedrick,
Headlight,
Frederick, Dibblin,
Baggins. Drew, it's your dad back with the
Duh,
milk.
Beautiful,
look
Megan,
Carmel S,
Amateur Archaeology,
Seven,
if you hear this,
the
I love
Mexican
you.
The Mexican 760.
Luxembourg Lover.
Tamron, and Zany Boy.